Hey, hello everyone. Sorry we're late. Welcome to hi, and this is camera pans. You see the inside of a truck. Roy's wearing a backwards baseball cap. Hey, and welcome to Roy's car vids. He puts on his wraparound.
Hey.
So I just want to talk about a bad Five Guys experience I had. This this burger flipper. I don't mean to say it, but she was Hispanic, and she was telling me that I was acting inappropriate in the store with my lewd behavior. So anyways, the cops get involved, and my parole officer, and... Sorry for the interruption. This is, Cannonwell.
We really gotta start locking the car. We can't...
Yeah, I just...
We can't allow Roy in the car.
I don't know how the feds keep taking my intros. I just...
Damn it, why do they keep stealing our intros? What the fuck were we doing? I can't even remember.
Oh, we were midway through.
Yeah, we were midway through. This is the problem when we, like, leave off midway through.
I just want to say... I was happy leaving midway through on this one because this case is unhinged.
Mm-hmm.
It's Noire, LA themed.
Right. All right. So I think if memory serves, we just left the house of a person who is suspected to have committed suicide. However, we believe that it was murder via overdose.
Mm-hmm.
And that was Julia Randall. So... We would have Dr. Stone's medical practice, I assume, and asinine dress store. Oh yeah, we're in unhinged time. Excellent, excellent. I am here for unhinged. So where would you like to go, Will? I don't know why.
Which ham do you want? I feel like we double-checked this, didn't we, with, like, evidence that we have?
Yeah, yeah.
Maybe we do a check-in. What evidence do we have of things?
We have the morphine that she supposedly took. The possible cause of death. The sleeping pills that she was also prescribed to help with depressions. The Benzedrine.
Ooh.
So you got your uppers, and then you got your downers. Excellent.
And then you got your side, two sides.
And then you got your men's smoking jacket, because Julia Randall apparently had men over frequently. Then you got a golden ring set with 2-carat black sapphire gemstone in it. I don't know where we found that. Our two suspects are, like, the ones that caused it. We just suspect that there were two people.
Okay. Do you have the framed photo from the living room?
I mean... Yes? It's the modeling job?
Okay.
Which is
then
a
we're good.
Framed,
then it is a bug.
Which is a framed photo from the living room? And the housekeeper's statement. Yeah, because it wasn't one of the photos, like... You know what? Let's just go in and we'll look at the photo. Mm-hmm. Just to be on the safe side.
Yeah.
Just to be on the safe side. If I remember correctly, there was a photo frame. It was like the middle one of three separate photos mm-hmm. that we could have looked at. And the back of it had a note being like, love of my life, we are gay as hell, let's do gay shit. Is this we can investigate further.
Oh yeah,
pop it out. Yeah,
now then it is the bug in
okay.
Which case
da-da-da-da.
40s themed Zelda noise.
I love that it stops the moment we leave the apartment. All right, so which place would you like to go to?
Apparently it doesn't matter.
Oh, interesting.
So do you want the Stone Man or Das in?
I don't know. Let's just go for the first one, which I think is Stone Man.
Ah, he's going to feel the rhythm with his hands.
Oh, yeah. Indeed. There is much rhythm to be felt here.
Well, you gotta feel the rhythm while you can.
Come on, Roy. Get in.
I don't think it actually failed. We did it, right? Where, like, you just leave him and then you get there?
Yeah. Yeah. Come on, bud.
But why not torment this guy?
Right?
He sucks.
Why not torment him just a little bit? Come on, bud. Come on, get in. All right, fine.
You know, Phelps, you don't stop with this. You're gonna turn my two-tone suit into a three-tone suit.
Wait, the little reunion in there almost brought a tear to my eye.
They're good police.
How would you know?
I thought it would do a cool, like, go in front of the person thing. It did not go in front of the person.
Galloway's a pushover. Galloway's a drunk.
You could learn a thing or two from both of them.
It did after, yeah.
They couldn't work a vice case.
And then the knee went in front of the person.
I don't see why they'd be any better or worse at it than me.
I noticed.
Luckily, that person has great stability, like stability of a mountain goat.
Kind of your trademark, don't you think?
Why do you always twist everything? Galloway's got nothing to prove. He's been on homicide for years.
And he's welcome to it. You're a terrier, Phelps. That's what I need.
We've been acting funny over the dialogue for this game, which is good.
Yeah,
I just...
Any available unit, the 44 suspect, we take it into custody as Sunset and Ibar. Unit A, code 2, identify.
Okay. You had an audible reaction to that one, so I'm going to do it. Plus, it's right.
I don't remember what it is. I just crave violence.
Against the odds.
I do know this one.
Ooh.
Again?
Detective Phelps.
Yeah.
You're going to have fun.
Phelps. I'm going to have fun.
A bagman named Rampley's going to walk in here and put a mint on some horse running.
No! No!
He's the one we're going to put away for fixing the wreck.
No!
You're hoping Rampley.
Why do the vice cases suck?
Here's what you're going to do. Get in there.
The other day, me and some people were hanging out watching a movie, and you were lucky not to be there because I finally made them watch The Crazy Strangler, and it's such a powerful movie. It's awful.
I do feel bad for missing that one, because I want to watch awful films. I'm here.
We should watch it together.
Okay. Excellent.
But there's a point where you could just quietly hear Gabe going, no, 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 no.
That's the guy from the paper. Solve that big case.
It's not like even like that awful a horror movie. It's just awful in powerful ways.
Oh,
it takes a skilled hand to make a movie that bad.
That makes sense. That's good. Yay, that.
Give me a grand on Cavalcade in the Fifth.
Okay, bye.
Note to self. Man has bet a piano.
Man has bet a piano?
A grand.
Oh, okay. I did not realize that was what that was called.
Well, he didn't call it an upright or a baby grand.
Fair enough.
Oh, also, very conspicuously taking cover works great.
That's fair. But when have I taken cover in this game? I love how it just... so obvious it is for all of this.
Hey, come on. This ain't New York.
What? What is this about New York? What?
You playing hide and seek, Mac?
Ooh, very close.
Hey, bud. Thanks for fucking ratting me out. Okay.
Ooh.
Thought he was gonna look. Thought he was gonna look. No, please don't make me follow the car.
Got it, boss.
It's a good thing you were so successful and stealthy leading up to that.
She's coming in at 20-1.
I'm a stealth master now.
LAPD, you're both under arrest.
Good job, Phelps. Okay.
This is my alley. It was meant for me.
This is my alley. No one else can fight me in it, all right? I've called dibs.
R11K calling KGPL. Ambulance required at Sunset and Ivar. Shots fired and suspects are down. We're code 4, but I'll need an ambulance in a corner.
Roger that, 11K. All units, be advised, the 44 at Sunset and Ivar is code 4. Suspects are down.
And now we get into the car and just fucking leave. Let anyone who wants to loot their bodies do so.
LAPD on the ground. Oh no, he's wearing his Colt 45 shooting plus 5 suit. You better get on the ground, boss.
Look, all I'm saying is don't fuck with Phelps. If Phelps had a pistol in the army, oh man. Wars would have gone real different. Give me a rifle, I'm useless.
He's rocking the Gat.
Yeah.
He's holding, he's got a piece.
Wonder if we have to go to where that open window is.
He's clocking that glizzy.
How many stupid things are you gonna say, Will?
He's got a big iron on his hip.
A big iron on his hip.
Someone walks into a bank, you're like, oh no, is this guy going to the town of Agua Fria?
Folk songs are great.
I swear, if we locked up every doctor in this town, Vice would be able to work half days.
Marty Robbins has a lot of songs that you don't realize are his.
Yeah, probably.
Then again, I say this as, I've learned this term. Apparently, I'm what the kids call an old head.
I see.
Ooh, hold on. Go into the options menu and go all the way back to the elevator.
Oh. Okay. Go all the way back to the elevator.
Oh, do this one in black and white. It's good in black and white.
Okay, options. Display. Black and white. On.
Just look at those blinds. There's so many blinds. They do the blinds thing. It's the blinds.
Oh, God. Yes.
Wow, Roy, your suit is slightly better.
Yeah, honestly, yes. In black and white, your suit is good. Go figure.
Yes, sir. Your name?
LAPD. We'd like to see Dr. Stoneman.
See, doesn't
Stoneman.
This feel better?
It does.
Dr. Stoneman is with a patient. Would you like to wait?
No, we wouldn't. Tell him we want to see him now.
There's
Except
no need to be
it's
rude.
The fact that Roy Same is sister. Talking, which kind
Dr.
of sucks.
Dr. Stoneman, I have some gentlemen from the LAPD here to see you.
Send them in, please. I'll see this patient again after they've left.
Oh, yes. You get the blind vision. Or you get the one,
Your investigation
like,
is much more important than
slip
my
of the blind
I'm
going
just
through.
Pain here. Leave me alone.
Careful. I could be a detective, or I could be a Dracula.
Oh, there's a kitchen here.
Voila!
They have a kitchen.
This
I must inspect.
To the case.
That's alright. You don't have to laugh, Roy. I'll do the orange thing. Just you wait.
I doubt
shit,
it.
Shit, I gave it away.
Oh, no.
Perhaps with the surprise of a lime. Yes, with green it will work.
Oh, that...
Dr. Stoneman?
That would be great. He's expecting the orange all of a sudden. Lime. Boom. Nailed it. Comedy gold right there.
Do you mind if we ask you some questions about Ms. Randall?
Not if it doesn't compromise doctor-patient privilege.
I'm reminded of a scene in Always Philadelphia, Always Sunny in Philadelphia, where they,
barely at all. She'd only been
they're trying to get one of the guys drunk, and all they do is go, okay, now I'm going to try doing the tequila shot. Am I doing it right? And then they keep doing it wrong over and over, so he keeps demonstrating with his own tequila shot. He's like, no, it's the lime before the... I don't know why you don't get this. The salt, the shot. Okay, so the shot, the salt. No, what are you...
I have a feeling this is already a lie.
Julia Randall has been your patient for nearly a year. I'm sure you know that.
Do you doubt my veracity, detective? Do you have access to my patient records?
And I'm assuming it's because of their prescription was in 46. I don't actually know what year it currently is, though.
47.
Yeah, buddy.
Man,
your prescription's contradicting,
tonight,
doctor.
DJ got us falling in love again.
Was in the fashion business, as you probably know. She was jumped up on Benzedrine by day and knocked down by sleeping pills at night. I told her to slow up, but no. Life was too short for her.
And you supplied the prescription for the Benzedrine.
It's not illegal, detective. A lot of young women in her line of work use it for weight loss.
Just like today.
Whee!
You wrote Julia Randall a prescription for Benzedrine. How can you account for that?
Miss Randall was in the fashion business. She wanted to control her weight.
Turns back to Roy, goes, hold on. I learned this off of TikTok. I'm gonna go alpha mode. Turns back. Whoosh.
I don't think he's telling us everything. I don't think anything that he said specifically is a lie. Let's just see.
We believe Ms. Randall died of an overdose of morphine. You didn't prescribe her anything else, did you?
That is a very serious allegation to level at a doctor, young man.
I mean... Yes. Was she prescribed sleeping pills? Like, I don't think any of this is a lie.
It's nothing personal.
I think you gotta push him.
My job.
Yep.
You understand that?
I'm just a little guy.
Benzedrine is addictive, as I'm sure you know, doctor.
As I warned her, but she was determined. She said she needed it to control her appetite.
Sounds like you knew her pretty well.
I knew the line of work she was involved in.
That'll be all for now, Dr. Stoneman. We'll be in touch.
Yep. That's about as interesting as the black and white mode gets. They don't really do much with it. Most of it is just like vaguely bright grays, which is not...
This isn't...
It's not called film light, you know?
Yeah.
Give me some drama.
Doesn't look like anything.
Like, film noir was a very, very specific art style. Nope. Hmm. Can't pick up the soap. I feel like this window is open for a reason. I also feel like we're gonna...
For drama.
For drama, yeah. I also feel like we're gonna leave this place and someone's gonna get thrown out it. Look at this. It's at knee height. That is not a safe window.
Nope.
Oh, hey. How's it going?
Bare minimum, you want it like, I don't know, a meter? Dick on the sill. That's your window height.
Yeah, dick on the sill is good. You don't want your, like, pivot point, i.e. your hips... Mm-hmm. To be capable of just kind of swinging over.
And if you have a plate glass window, cock bar.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Maybe a chest bar for the additional support if it's all the way up to the ceiling.
I don't think we have anything else to do here. Kind of just ask the questions. And there's no more music, so... Unless we can get in here. No. Okay.
Didn't even give us the satisfying jingle.
Didn't even give us a satisfying jingle.
I'm calling the cops.
Yeah, right? Game busted.
Hello, Ontario Provincial Police. I'd like to report a bug in LA Noire.
I wonder what the About most what? Just asinine call has
I
ever been.
I don't know. He looked relieved when you said she was dead.
I think there's a weird to the death of a young patient. Sorting to it, where it's like the people who make those calls probably make a lot of those calls.
Yeah. He's not going for the car because he knows that I'm going to just go for a different car. Ooh, he knows I'm just fucking.
He could snag a hidden vehicle. Something ritzy.
Here we go.
Get up the map. Get something special. Get something nice.
What you doing? You gonna get in? Right there, bud. Right there. You can just climb right over the seat. Just... Alright.
It would be inappropriate, Phelps.
This is my car! There we go. I had to hit a light post because you wouldn't get in. The
physician-patient privilege card when they got some to hide.
There are certain things people have a right to keep private.
Until it gets in the way of police work. And it's only private when it suits them. A couple of drinks and every doctor I've met will spill your darkest secrets in a heartbeat.
I mean, isn't doctor-patient confidentiality only extend to while they were alive? Is it after death, too?
All units in the vicinity and any central unit. Citizen reports a 415 okay, and 7 central. Point.
This unit one to or car? Code 2, identify. I have one you'll like.
Okay, let's go car.
All right. It's in a residential garage between Hollywood and Wilshire.
Hollywood. Where's Wilshire?
I think Wilshire's another one of those, like, you're doing the sideways. So it's going to be another one of those long ones, maybe south past Sunset.
Okay. I don't... Oh. Okay, so... There's a hidden vehicle here. Do you think this is it?
We can go for any of them, but I have one you're going to like.
Okay. There's one there.
There's I think Hollywood. It's a lot further south, because there's like a whole Wilshire division, which is south of here.
There's a hidden vehicle up here.
Ooh.
The hidden vehicle down here.
There's a lot of them.
That's Wilcox. That's not it. Sadly. Is it this far down?
What do we got? What are our horizontal streets right now?
Oh, I see. There's Wilshire Division. There's Hollywood Division. So it's somewhere in between here. So we got a hidden vehicle, Julia Randall's apartment, a hidden vehicle.
Okay. I've got near Melrose, Wilton, and Western.
Well, there's Melrose, Western, and Wilton.
Boom, there it is.
Okay, all right. We're going on a brief detour.
This is some fucking Fallout bullshit. I hope you like this car. It's not the shape a car should be.
Oh, speaking of Fallout, I saw that there was a trailer put out for the mod for Fallout 4 that's Fallout London.
Ooh. Ontario?
No. Not.
Aw.
Although, I would love for us to play through that entire mod as if it was Ontario.
If there's ever... I think that it makes a lot of sense for nothing, even though, like, canonically Canada's part of the U.S.
What
and, like,
are you doing?
Yeah.
Like, I think it makes sense for it to all be American because it's about, like, a period in American history and a whole bunch of other stuff.
Yeah.
But, like, if there's ever a Fallout Detroit, you better... Have us take the fucking bridge up through fucking.
Yes. Give there us better Port be Huron. A fucking I want Canada Windsor DLC.
And Sarnia. At least let me get to London, Ontario, and have it be the worst. St. Thomas is just a raider den.
I mean, that's super fucking accurate. St. Mary's is like a weird safe haven that everyone has already died in. but like was utopian until the raiders from St. Thomas came.
From New Vegas, I just assumed that every quarry has death claws in it.
I mean, that's valid.
Including my own.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, there's death claws in your quarry. They're just waiting to pop up.
They're slow, quiet creatures when they're unseen.
Yeah. I mean, it's an evolutionary trait from their time as a gecko. Because they were fucking geckos.
I think horned chameleons, specifically.
I see.
And it's very funny that they chose just like a fun little Tricera guy.
Yeah.
Just your little friend.
That's absolutely fucking insane that they're just like, you know what? Yeah, this guy. This is what comes to mind when I think Deathclaw.
Are we undercover now? Put the siren on.
No. This is not the right alley. Or is it?
This car cost me a fortune, you moron.
Yeah, Roy needs to fucking chill.
The gold handle.
Sorry, what was that, Will?
Gold handle garage.
Gold handle garage.
Then I have to go in through a door to get out through the garage door.
Nope, that is not gold handled. Thought it was.
Did you check the one you were right next to?
Hmm?
Because you parked right next to one.
I did?
Yeah. No, it's not that
one. Not that one. Okay. Well, I guess it could be here. Let me just check on the map for the specific spot. Let's get a little bit more nitty gritty with it. All right.
Okay. Next street, far side.
Yep. Not that one. Oh, there you go. Yeah, that's a bit of a giveaway.
Hope you like it.
Oh my god. Let's get a look-see at this bad boy. Aw, yeah. A fucking three-wheeled car. This looks so goofy ass.
I thought you might want to be a shoe.
I do want to be a shoe. It's my lifelong dream to actually be a shoe. That way everyone can just step on me as a job.
Mm-hmm.
Truly.
As opposed to it being their job.
Oh yeah, no. When it's their job, it's, you know, not as fun for me.
Man, it handles, doesn't it?
It fucking does, yeah. Like, it doesn't really have the top speed, but fuck, this thing handles. The drive back is going to take twice as long, but it's going to be worth it with this goofy thing.
We can always make Roy do it.
Ah, where's the fun in that? Actually, the idea of Roy being forced to drive this thing around town is pretty great.
Keeping my eyes on this. I'm gonna keep a short list for fucking good shit.
For good shit? Alright, perfect. That's what we
got
want.
Got a Batmobile in my pocket.
What?
It's not the Batmobile, but it looks like that.
Okay. I'm assuming it's near the Hollywood set. Like one of the film sets.
You see a couple of guys doing a weird, like, squatting walk on a rope, just like... I love how obviously those scenes were shot at a 90-degree angle.
Yeah, but it's so adorable, right? Like, yeah. Sometimes you see film techniques and you can't help but just be like, oh, that's the cutest fucking thing ever.
Like... There's a lot of old, like, legacy media projects where they're like, okay, we're going to do Batman for the Gen Alphas.
Yeah.
Version 3, subsection 2 for the next 3-season span.
Yeah.
And occasionally, all the really successful ones, they're basically just like, What if it was a little stupid the way the originals were? Those are the ones that were.
One moment. I'm actually going to have to tab out. Ah, everything's screwed up. I need to up your audio. Tragedy. You are a little quiet for me.
Me?
Yes.
A quiet?
You are a quiet. Hang on. I'm getting the game back. I'm getting the game back together.
Look, I'll snipe for you, but I'm not wearing the outfit.
You're wearing the outfit, Will. You'll wear the outfit and you'll like it. Here we go. Onwards, back to the objective. I don't even have to slow down when we come to like corners.
It's just so bad at taking them that it just accelerates.
Yeah. Also, I like the idea of doing this because the front would be the worst suspension ever. Mm-hmm. Kind of go back and forth and see how it goes.
It's so tippy.
It's just the tippy.
Illegible dark art deco. Fucking
Christ.
It's just a squiggle.
I love art deco except for signs.
Mm-hmm.
This, you know what? This I'm somewhat okay with because it has a symmetry going. It's almost symmetrical. I'm almost okay with it.
It's not called Art Describe.
Yeah.
Well, hello. What can I help you with today?
We'd like to yell at you as well, ma'am.
I hope I haven't done anything wrong.
No, ma'am. We're making some inquiries about Julia Randall. Does she work here?
No, I had to let her go. Is she in some sort of trouble?
She's super dead.
She was found dead this morning. How long had Julia worked as a model?
Hello, random woman in the background.
She worked in New York before coming here. She was a very beautiful girl.
I mean, okay.
She kind of has the... I understand that the roller coaster is about to go down face. She's got, like, both hands on the bar. She is neutral. She is waiting for the experience. She is staring dead ahead.
Yeah, like... How long has Julia worked as a model? She worked in New York before coming here. She was a very beautiful girl. Oh, okay.
But how long?
Like, do I truth this? Like, this seems like a truth. Just like, okay, kind of get explaining a little bit more.
I don't think you're fucking with me. I think you just haven't told me what I need to know.
Yeah.
Could you tell us why you let Miss Randall go?
Husbands sometimes come in here with their wives. When Julia Randall modeled, the husbands were often more interested in her than they were their wives' dresses. The wives weren't happy, and neither was I.
Did she have any close friends here?
We asked one question?
Yes. Heather Swanson.
Just one? We have no follow-ups.
Please don't inform her about Miss Randall's death.
Very well, officer. Heather?
Ma'am, only one question. Are you titted? Ma'am, sorry, is she? Yes, was she titted? What? The dead woman. Was she titted or was she bapped? Did she have cakes in the behind?
Julia helped me get my job here.
She's fucking titted up.
She's not in any kind of trouble, is she?
She's a hellraiser, isn't she? Lives a fast life.
Oh, no. Maybe Mrs. Stanley would call her that, but I wouldn't. She's full of life. Wonderful company.
That's a lovely engagement.
She does not know.
Do you like it?
Yeah.
Henry gave it to me.
I'm very interested in engagement.
Scotty doesn't know that her friend is dead.
She probably slept with her fiancé.
That's some pearl, Miss Swanson. Would have cost Henry a fortune.
Well, you know what they say. Really pearls before Swanson.
How did you meet Julia?
Yep.
Henry Arnett.
God, that was terrible.
I happened to be drinking at the time. It wasn't bad. I was drinking, you see.
The silence afterwards. I'm like, I'm sitting there. Pun pops into your brain. Immediately goes out, right? Bypasses all filters. Goes out into the world.
Meanwhile, I have about an ounce of Grolsch in my glottis.
And I am met with nothing.
Well, it could be worse. You could have been met with Arl.
That's true. How'd you meet Julia? I was introduced through my fiancé, Henry Arnett. Okay.
Tell me about this fiancé.
Yeah.
Henry is your beau. Tell us about him.
Yes, he is. Henry has a fashion business. He and Julia have been friends for years.
I see.
Are Miss Randall and Mr. Henderson engaged?
Who's he?
Oh!
She doesn't know!
Scotty doesn't know!
She doesn't know! Oh no! This feels like a truth because she looks like she doesn't know.
Ooh, this is gonna hurt.
She was wearing a sapphire engagement ring. Someone must have given it to her.
She never mentioned a man named Henderson to me.
That's all for now, Miss Bonson. Could you ask your fiancé to visit Hollywood Police Station? It would be very helpful to our inquiry.
Now, wait a moment. I don't think I'll pass on that message until you tell me why you're asking all these questions.
Julia Randall was found dead this morning.
What? Oh, no.
I kind of wish she had backed up enough to knock over the vase.
So yeah, right. Just kind of like, oopsie poopsie, knock over a vase.
Oh, this fucking car.
Everything is wrong about this fucking car.
Cole Phelps, badge 1247.
How could I help, Detective?
Hey, operator.
Messages for me, please.
Yes, Detective. The coroner's been asking to speak to you. I can connect the call if you like.
Please, thank you. Al?
Cole, can you get over here? I just finished the autopsy.
Sure thing, Mal. We'll be
right
over.
Didn't need to connect the call to do that. All right.
She just goes, all right, Phelps, you're a good boy. Have a good night. He's like, I'm a good... It hangs up. He's like, I'm a good boy.
The Roy, only thing...
Can you drive, Roy? Can I...
I'm a good boy. The only thing that would make this better is those, like, incredibly rounded horse, like, trailers attached the back of this. So you get this weird-ass round-edge thing, and then you get, like, an oval cylinder hanging off the back.
That's the funny thing about, like, cars over the years, is that there's a period after designing for aerodynamics. There's a period where cars were getting fast enough that it mattered. Then there's a period before where they just made them shaped, and it's deceptive, because you'd think they're aerodynamic, but these things couldn't go that fast.
These things are not that aerodynamic. I mean...
They're like full steel chassis, like...
Like, they have some aerodynamics, but so does a brick. Like...
Nice move not telling old Sweet Lips in there about her friend taking the big jump till we were half out the door. Very slick.
I figured we'd get more out of her that way.
You're learning, Phelps. We'll make a vice cop out of you yet.
No, you will not. I look forward to not you.
Hey. Okay. This thing had one of two engine options. It was either a 47 or a 63 horsepower.
It's pretty solid.
And it had a 3-speed transmission.
Excellent. But what do you mean it's not aerodynamic?
So what next?
May as well get this over with. Let's go and hear Mouse Ferry.
I need to do something again. I fucked up when I tabbed out. I fucked up, Will.
No!
I fucked up. I no longer had, like, the stream. I couldn't see chat without, like, looking over hard right.
Oh, that's not good for your neck.
Yeah, like, I have to go just a full k- and basically, like, crack my neck in order to read chat. So I'm just gonna do that.
Yeah, that could be... Actually, you know, I'm just gonna... No, I need one of those.
Oh yeah, you need one of those. Okay, let's
kind
of
to the
kind of get it
to the right. Let's
get it a good going.
Push it.
Yeah.
There it is.
Oh, for me it was left. Oh, always go left. Yeah, never go hard right.
My body is incorrect.
my body has several issues. We can't go in here. All right. How nice of you to keep the door open.
I have some information for you.
You're the only person enjoying this, Mal. Get on with it.
The bruising confirms two sets of hands, so we have two killers. Death was caused by heart failure due to an overdose of morphine.
Have you dragged us down here to gloat? We already heard your theory.
We agree that she was murdered.
Yes.
Roy, that's my friend!
Nothing else to show you.
All right, Mal, what gives?
The dead guy's name is Jimmy
Roy! Frank,
career burglar. He came in this morning. Someone stove his head in with a lump of 2x4.
So what?
Yeah.
Good riddance.
I found
Roy, you do not talk shit to my friend. Wow.
Hang on a minute, Roy. We're listening now. No sign of morphine use and no metabolized morphine in his blood. Scratch marks on his face.
Roy, go sit outside.
From getting his head remodeled.
Time of death, Mal. Maybe an hour or two after the Randall girl.
Roy, the grade 12s are talking.
Boy here could be one of our killers? That's a hell of a long shot.
Thanks, Mal. We'll check it out.
I found something else.
Can I look at your toesies? Damn it.
Roy just, like, gets angrier and angrier as the rest of them do their jobs. He's like, whatever, I'm gonna jump up and down outside until I have to fart, and I'm gonna fart on their feet when you, like, think about that. Mal.
Think about that, yeah.
Sorry, I don't play. I don't know if it's significant. His wallet was empty. The only other things he was carrying were the harmonica and the morphine.
I see. Maybe the harmonica contained the morphine.
Yeah, he's here.
This is before the day where people weren't worried about germs. Give it a whistle and see if it goes.
Henry Arnett in interview 2 for you next door. Let me know how you get on.
Sure, Mal. And thanks for the lead.
Sure, Mal. Thanks for the lead.
Roy!
I want to hit Roy with the car again. Roy, you're getting run over by this egg. And I hope you realize why. Damn it! Oh, is there still stuff in here?
Henry Arnett.
Henry Arnett,
you say?
Oh, it just donged.
Does the dong mean it's done?
Oh wait, this one is physically connected. There's like a weird little overhang you gotta go through, and then you're in the police station.
This isn't it. This is outside. Are you sure?
It's in the same, like, little plaza. Because there's a police station, which is like...
Oh, okay. I went the wrong way. Isn't that the cop who won the... I swerved when I should have... Swooned?
Deeked?
Deeked? Yeah.
Oh, look at that stupid car.
It's so fucking beautiful.
It's so sleek. It's so modern. It's so bad.
Nope. That ain't it. I think it's in interview room 2. Yeah, there he is.
Oh. You walk in, Roy just sits down on the other side. He goes, "So Cole, are you gay? Do your parents know you're gay? For coming in.
You are so nice to another man. That must mean you are the gay."
Roy leans in, he goes, "Hey Cole. Julia Randall. Baby. Loses his way.
I'm in the clothing business and Julia occasionally modeled for me."
Loses his way.
Loser says what? All right.
It's like, oh man. Turns back directly towards the fucking double pane glass. No one's in the room. He's like, "Ah, this guy's playing hardball." Looks like Cole to see his reaction. Both hands on the desk, full forward.
Yep, full fucking forward.
"Come clean with us, Arnett. Was Miss Randall your mistress? Is that how she could afford such a lavish lifestyle?" "That's a ridiculous allegation. How could you possibly prove that I paid for Julia's things?"
Okay, I don't think we actually...
I don't know about that.
I don't think we have anything like that. Except for a nice smoking jacket. Jewelry. I mean, the four ring set with four grain pearl with the gold ring set with 2 carat.
I keep thinking of the dress store and I see housekeeper statement and I imagine you hovering over it and it's like, housekeeper had like a peach thing going with like a little green belt with like a leaf motif. Worked.
If that's underscored twice.
Just gonna say it. Get home. Worked. Alright, I don't think this is... Yeah. Like, they were definitely boinking, but I'm not sure what would prove it. Except for, like, the ring.
We could go boo-woo-woo.
Sorry?
Like, territorial dog.
Stick.
Yep. I think we just boo-boo-woo. This guy, I definitely doubt him, though, right? Like, he's fucking lying. Introduced his fiance through her.
He's smarmy.
Yeah.
He's got lapels.
He's asking whether you banged her in a chuck on the shoulder fraternity kind of way.
I'm engaged to be married. It wouldn't be.
Why would you phrase it like that? The fuck, Roy? They won't have to know. Roy has said so much shit, but that one, for some reason, is like, Jesus fucking Christ, dude.
Miss Randall's landlady said she was seeing an older man.
Hey, Roy, you want to stand really close to this compressed air container? I'm just going to do some target practice, all right? Don't worry. Don't worry. Don't worry.
I feel the need to power wash all of Roy.
No, you can't give in to such hate. Do it with love. Sandblast.
It makes sense. Yes. All right.
It's a bit too small for my tiny screen.
What is the text?
They will ruin shoulder. That's Myers. So Neil. Yes, we had relationship. Miss Junfall's lordaddy said she was wearing an older man.
She was wearing an older man. Kinky.
It just needs one more pixel.
Yeah, fair enough. All right, so
what are we thinking?
I'm engaged to be married. It wouldn't be polite. Answer the question. This will remain private. Heather won't have to know. Yes, we had relations. Miss Randall's landlady said she was seeing an older man. Could have been. I wasn't privy to the details of Julia's private life. You literally just said you're having an affair, so fair enough. But
you're privy.
You're literally privy, but all right.
Henry, I don't like when people lie to me. She was seeing a man named Henderson. You know who I'm talking about.
Easy on, detective. I may have heard of Henderson, but I don't know his full name. I think he's from New York or someplace back east.
Do I need to find someone to look after me meanwhile?
What the fuck was that? There was nothing to catch in a lie? There was no question that I'm answering here? Oh. 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 Well, maybe this would work. Yeah. You know what? Let's go with it.
That's funny. Julia told her cleaning lady that he lived in San Francisco.
Okay, you got me. I don't know where he's from. Julia wanted money. She always wanted money.
Money is a nice thing.
Get some from this guy. She was wearing a distinctive engagement ring. I also always
want money.
She might have convinced him to buy it for her. Maybe he did. Yeah. Maybe he and Julia were getting serious.
Payments.
Yeah.
Ever heard of a Jimmy LeBlanc?
So many payments.
No.
And the bills.
Should I have? Is he an entertainer or something?
You do not. You're not aware of Matt LeBlanc, star of hit TV show Friends, and also was in Charlie's Angels.
Hi, I'm Matt LeBlanc. Answer the question.
Oh, you were talking about bad movies earlier. Charlie's Angels, such a quality bad movie.
They knew what they were doing. You know, they knew.
It's a bad movie that you can really enjoy, except some scenes have not aged well. As with all early 2000s films.
I was trying to fall asleep watching The Mask the other day, and like, there definitely was an era of Hollywood cinema where they would just be like, ah, yes, Cameron Diaz. Do boob or butt. Congratulations. Do it for 30 minutes, please. Over a 1 hour runtime, interspersed with other scenes. Now be in peril? Cool. Here's $200,000.
Yeah. Yeah. It's good times. It's good times. Yeah, just saying that scene, just saying about that scene, Cameron and Lucy were in that scene too and didn't wear that makeup. Yeah, yeah, that's true. There is specifically a scene where Cameron Diaz and Lucy Liu are doing a belly dance, as you do, in order to distract some men so that Drew Barrymore is able to steal their drink to get their, like, DNA sample or something. And all I could say is that Drew Barrymore's outfit was a fucking choice that would not pass today. She really wanted to blend in with the atmosphere. None of the other actresses wore it, though.
Listen, it, I mean, it's half of the word, right? If you're a Caucasian, you can.
I think Randall was a high-priced hooker.
No!
I didn't want it to come out that he had been seen.
No!
I think he had LeBlanc and an accomplice.
Yeah, the scene was already questionable because they had done several, like, let's get women half-naked from various country stereotypes. But, like, yikes. Yeah, Drew just wanted to be authentic.
There's a Bond movie where he gets plastic surgery to become Japanese.
Wait. What?
We should watch the Bond movie where he gets plastic surgery to become Japanese.
No, sorry, I heard that, and yes, 100%. I needed to reread the accusations. I think Randall was a high-priced hooker, alright, and this Henderson character didn't want it to come out that he's been seeing her. I think he had LeBlanc and an accomplice bump her off, and I think you know who Henderson is and are trying to conceal his identity. Okay, I read, prove that I know who Henderson is, and I'm like, we were talking about LeBlanc. What the fuck?
Mm-hmm.
Oh yeah, they dressed as geishas. Charlie's Angels just wanted to make sure they checked all the boxes. Yep. Anyway, back to accusing this person.
Lucy Liu on set taking deep breaths.
Taking deep breaths, off the hook, trying not to get fired from the film, and also yelled at by Bill Murray.
It's a representation, Lucy. He's just a weird Groundhog Day guy, Lucy.
You want to know the best part? I looked up something else. Guess how much each of the three actresses was paid. They were each paid a different amount, between $1 and $15 million.
Cameron top, Drew Barrymore mid, Lucy Liu bottom.
Yes, close.
Lucy Liu, six figures versus other people, heaven seven.
Yeah. So here's what it was. Drew Barrymore, who was actually the producer, got paid the most at $12 million.
Okay.
She produced the film, so that's fair all. Enough. She got a return on investment on that.
I probably need to get home.
Cameron Diaz, $9 million. And Lucy Liu, $1 million.
Okay, that is seven.
Yeah, yeah. It was.
It is funny when, like, really, really rich people are doing stuff, especially, like, actors bidding for, like, the prices they're going to pay for things, because so much of it is just vibes. At which point, so it's like. You
wouldn't have any reason to believe okay, that like, would if, be involved in Julie Randall's murder.
One person has a $2
sandwich. This guy is a criminal. He might have been involved.
One person has a $5 sandwich. One person has a $20 sandwich.
Yeah.
I think I know what those mean. At a certain level of rich, it's like, okay, you come to me and you're like, all right, I'll star in your movie for like $80 million. It's like, I don't know if that's a lowball and you're going to do a shit job just because you're rich and sought after. Like, I don't know what that means.
Yeah, like, are you Nicolas Cage and you need to repay your tax fraud? Or is this like...
Fighting sixth. You were in the
sixth. Like, can you submit an hour sheet?
Which company?
What's the going rate?
We had a lot of casualties.
Yeah, what's your EI premium on this?
Yeah.
A couple of other places. That'll be all for now, Henry. You've been very helpful.
That son of a bitch was never in the Marines. Why'd you let him off the hook?
Because we're giving him a couple of minutes before we start tailing him.
No!
As an amateur, we need to find out who killed the girl. Can you pass this on to Bukowski? Have him check the place out and go through his records.
Sure, I'll pass it on.
Thanks. Can you also
to the superior partner,
Jimmy LeBlanc, and find out who was his last arresting officer? Have him get in touch with the KGPL when they
see Rusty's better at being a cop, but Bukowski is paying attention.
Yeah. Bukowski wants to be Phelps. Rusty does not want to be
Phelps.
He's
in that car at the lights.
Roy really wants to be Phelps, but he doesn't want to be Phelps.
Oh, yeah. He wants to act like he doesn't want to be Phelps, but he wishes he was Phelps.
Can you quit driving like a jackass
also,
already?
He's
squirming like a worm in there. Don't you love it when they pull the war hero excuse? Actually, maybe you don't.
Oh. Okay, now there's just a bunch of cars. Let's go.
I'd have expected a cad like Arnett to be a better liar.
We're going. We're tailing. There we go. Bro, your car is too fast. We need more of a brick.
Something in a shoe.
Yeah, something in a shoe variety would be nice. A big blue shoe. If we could get that, that would be cool. It's just so awkward.
Where are you taking us, Henry?
Like, genuinely, I think The Simpsons Hit and Run had a better stealth mechanic than this. At least The Simpsons Hit and Run, you could get right up behind them, so it looked a little bit more natural. Then again, The Simpsons Hit and Run vehicles did not drive naturally, so...
Too close, Phelps. Way too close.
realize this dude was a grandma. Let's go.
Skill.
You got a pretty funny idea of what's keeping a low profile.
I wanted to turn in there, and then I was just like, no, I don't know if it exits properly.
That idiot never stepped foot in Okinawa.
Come on. Come on. For some reason, I had go through my head a Simpsons discussion that was Homer saying that he's from Scotland, and then Groundskeeper Willie being like, "I'm from Scotland," just trying to lie to him. Then he asks him where he's from, and he names some location, and then Willie asks if he knew some people. And Homer's just like, "There, those people don't live in that town. You're not Scottish at all."
Get in there and find out what he pawned. I'll stick with him, see how he intends to spend the money. Move in. Can't risk losing the trail.
Puff it, Phelps. I'll bring the car around when I'm done here.
I'm tree.
You can be shop window.
I could be shop window. I want to be tree, though.
Too much slack. Gotta get closer.
You don't see me. You don't see me.
Move in. At risk losing the trail.
Yeah, too much slack. Stop slacking, Phelps.
Too much slack. Gotta get closer.
What do you mean?
What are you doing?
Fucking see me. Like, gotta get closer. What do you want from me? Unskippable cutscenes. Does that lady know what's fast. Up? Like, she specifically stops and like starts looking at everything. I guess she was looking for some.
See how he intends to spend the money. Move in.
Looking for some cheap deals.
Puff it, Phelps.
She's like, oh no, a 40s man.
I must divert my gaze.
He might have a hat.
He might not have a hat.
Even worse.
Yeah.
Too much slack.
Swear to God, Phelps.
He might be a goth or be from Cisalpine Gaul.
Move in. Risk losing the trail.
Thankfully, he didn't see me there.
Too much slack.
Swear to God, Phelps. I'm gonna go a little wide.
Move in. At risk losing the trail.
Nope, you didn't see me. Damn it.
No!
Too much slack. Why? Too much slack. Too much slack. Too much slack. Too much slack.
It doesn't make any sense.
Too much
You're
slack.
Fine.
I specifically went wide. I specifically went wide.
He needs money and fast.
You know what? I'm gonna walk on the other side of the street.
Get in there and find out what he pawned. I'll stick with him, see how he intends to spend the money. Too much slack.
Swear to God, right as I get out of the car, seriously? Too much slack.
At risk losing the trail.
Too much slack. I'm tired of speaking to my coworkers.
What are you doing? What do you mean, what am I doing? I'm on the other side of the street. Fuck you.
I'm getting a sandwich.
No. No, I refuse to skip this fucking sequence. The stealth mechanics will not beat me in this game. Yeah. Hey, I'm just walking here. What do you want? You're the one that's suspicious for calling me out while I'm, you know, just walking down the street.
He just turns around and points. He's like, that man's a policeman. Everyone just looks at him. Looks at you. Just keeps walking.
Get in there and find out what he pawned.
No one fucking cares. I'll stick with him.
See how he intends to spend the money. Too much slack. Gotta get closer.
Hoof it, Phelps. I'll bring the car around when I'm done here.
You are the worst, Phelps.
Don't try to be a person in the world.
At risk losing the trail.
That would be suspicious behavior.
Right? And grab this newspaper. Go incognito. Yeah, Phelps needs to chill on the slack. Get, like, Discord, a little bit of Blue Sky, maybe. I signed up for Blue Sky today. I now have a Blue Sky account. Slack.
Gotta get close. You get all the people who were just a little bit too mad at Twitter for Twitter.
Yeah, exactly.
Or people who said anything about Musk.
Exactly. Okay, going across the street. I'm going to just... I am walking across the street. I was expecting him to just turn around and be like, what are you doing?
I know, the second that, like, sour bass note hit, I was like, oh, no.
Okay, should be good. Where'd he go? Oh shit, really caught up to him. Too much slack.
Oh, mercy.
Thank God.
That's right, Mexico City. One-way ticket, please. Next available seat.
That would be one day from now. Is that okay?
It's going to have to be.
You could, like, get out of town. Rent a car and drive there?
Just came in here. He bought a ticket?
Yes, sir.
Maybe you didn't do scouts as a kid. Maybe you can't take a little log shack.
You know what? Fair enough. He's a man of class.
What have you got?
He bought a ticket from Mexico City. Tomorrow night.
That's good. But this is better.
Oh, fun.
It's Fabergé.
Should have seen the look on the pawnbroker's face when I told him to hand it over. The guy who owned the joint thought it was worth at least 10 large for a cigarette case. Arnett only got 600 clams.
Ah. Oh, really scammed the guy. All right. Here is Beverly. With love and affection. Always. Ah. It's not tracking to anything, so I'm assuming...
P.J.? C, Q.
I want to say that's a J. Yeah, it's the guy's fault for accepting clams instead of money. Well, maybe you wanted to go to Bikini Bottom or something. Hell fun. Operator. Operator. Let's talk to operator.
Want a new car?
You know I do.
Operator, give me R&I.
through now.
Phelps, 1247.
How could I help, Detective?
Any messages?
Telephone is backwards.
Yes, Detective.
On this
Detective Spakowski and Galloway request you return to Hollywood Station. They have information in the Julia Randall case.
Any luck with the arrest record check on Jimmy LeBlanc?
I guess it's
yes,
just
Detective.
A solid sign.
Jimmy LeBlanc's last arresting officer
yeah,
was
I guess
patrolman
this is
Fred
an outpointer.
Wallace. He's posted the Hollywood 9th Beat Sunset Boulevard between Gordon and Wilcox.
Thank you.
All right, we have new locations.
I think his name is Phelps. He brought in the case for that poor lady killed near City Hall.
All right, do you want the Chrysler Woody, the Phantom Corsair, or the Stout Scarab?
Oh, you know I want a Woody.
Okay, it's in a residential garage at the end of a long alley that starts at 7th Vermont Avenue in Wilshire.
Vermont Avenue in Wilshire. Nope.
Hmm.
Long alley, you say?
This... Avenue. Santa Monica Vine. Where's 7th?
That is an excellent question. Where's 1st? Then we'll be able to go from there.
Yeah, who's on 3rd?
Yeah. All right. Let's go a little bit. What was the neighborhood? Do you know?
I'm not sure, but they mentioned Wilshire, so I'm sure it's Wilshire.
Okay. Want to make sure. Okay, so in here. Well, there's 8th, and there's 7th. It's got to be
Vermont,
this one.
Wilshire. Yeah.
Got to be that
Maybe
one.
Maybe should make Roy drive. It's a little ways.
How do I actually do that?
On console, it's like the hold drive button instead of pressing.
Okay.
Can you drive to this one?
Hey.
Nailed it.
A
and of course, we're not taking
your Mexico.
Car.
Old Henry's looking as guilty as a dog next to a pile of dog shit.
What's his motive?
I can think of a few. But I'd put my money south of the belt.
Yeah,
one
this
guy
is scenic
plus two
as shit.
Games always equal problems.
Roy drives exactly how I would expect him to drive.
Mm-hmm. Really lane changey.
Yeah. Okay, I think we're over there. He drove me to what is quite possibly the worst location for this. But,
oh yeah, it's like in.
Yeah, we'll get there.
Grown men playing at being boys.
I think he's a bit of a gangster. But...
Yeah, come on, up, hop this fence. Damn it! Hey, there it is.
Yeah.
Oh, that's a Woody right there.
It's so Woody.
Yeah, I'm also a bit of a gangster. Yeah.
She drinks whiskey like water.
The cross beam.
It's fucking paneling. This is great.
They release a Chrysler Waddle and Daub. You can't drive it any faster than like 50 an hour, otherwise the bits of Daub fall off. You have a threshed roof that keeps coming off when you go over.
I love the idea that you have a car inspired by a mud hut. Just kinda whatever. But
what the hell?
Also, can I just say how fucking terrible this thing looks?
Oh, it's so bad.
Like, the wood paneling actually looks great, but it completely clashes with the fucking metal...
Son of a bitch!
The metal fucking rims and everything.
Oh, yeah, there's no... they didn't make the decisions, you know?
Like, it's one or the other. You cannot have both. You absolutely cannot have both.
I would love to see a wood fucking panel car
look
in the water.
Look where you're going!
Jesus, my paint job!
Your paint job?
Our wood! Our wood is gonna burn! Well, this is just awkward. Actually, this one reminds me more of the shoe. Well, that,
sorry, madam. Police
that
officer.
Car lasted about as long as a wooden car. As long as I would expect a wooden car to last.
Diseases be eradicated. Delicious and creamy Spencer's beer is your producer of this special broadcast.
You're right, I am.
I most Spencer's certainly am. Provide
you with a front row seat to America's favorite radio entertainment.
Yeah, I don't understand why Roy can be so mad. That wasn't even his car. Like, come on.
There's no need to put up with
limitless limits here.
Wartime brands. 8 out of 10 say Spencer's tastes.
I have to be
delicious.
Mad. So otherwise, I go insane.
Relax.
Like,
that's why I'm posting, Phelps.
No. No, he posts on Twitter mad.
That's why I rage bait on our relationships, Phelps. Yeah, I'm a fake poster, but it's not like you're a real poster.
Yeah, Phelps is on there talking about how, like, he wants to help his wife and everything like that because he feels absent because he works all the time. And then there's Roy posting, like, is it all right that, you know, my partner just kind of pees on me occasionally? They say it's a joke, but they keep doing it. I've said that it makes me uncomfortable and asked them to stop, but they won't stop. What do I do?
I decided to draw the line the other day because of the chips incident.
No, not the chips incident.
You can guess what happened with the chips incident. Parentheses, a little got in my chips. But when I think of you,
I was just thinking of a story that I actually did read on there where a person's basically getting a divorce over mustard. Yeah, no one wants soggy chips. That's terrible.
Now, a nice sloppy steak, that's different.
Oh, yeah.
No need to kick someone out of a restaurant over that.
Yeah. But, like, chips are, you know, necessary to be nice and crispy. Where is this guy?
Thank God we're not in my car.
Keep the piss out of the chips, yes. Please, can we all agree, please do not piss in the chip bowl. That is a communal bowl.
Understood. I'll cut a hole at the bottom and piss out of the chip bowl.
No! Where are our neighbor's keys supposed to go? We just got the pineapple to put out front, Will.
What are you doing?
If you want piss chips, please get a little bowl of your own chips and piss in the bowl. This little teeny tiny bowl.
There's like minuscule serving bowls at the table that are just full of different people's labeled piss.
Yeah, like a fucking red Solo cup, but it's just a red serving bowl.
You're advertising pineapple. On the table, they're like rusty.
Rusty, did you take someone else's bowl? Well, you see, Phelps, I thought what would happen is we would trade. So I discussed it with the person, and we consensually decided to agree to trade bowls. However, I did misread which bowl it was supposed to be. I forgot that there were two Mary Ann's at the party.
Radio Entertainment is on KTI Radio 760.
Anyways, all's to say, if you can come to this address, I'm tired after a gangbang, and I really thought I was getting the chip bowl.
I was I was told the chip bowl would be mine after this. No, you don't need to clean it. I'll just take it back.
Miss Truman later made an appeal for contributions to the Infantile Paralysis Fund drive to replace $7.5 million spent during the severe 1946 epidemic.
Okay, I completely misheard the news report that's going on over the radio.
Goddamn maniac!
And I thought it was they were going to replace 7.5 cows that went missing, and I'm like, how the fuck does that work?
Give him a hand.
You were in a car! You were in a fucking car!
I'm going right after this little prick in the alley.
You sent seven cows and one that's been through some shit.
Yeah.
Can I even call myself a cow anymore?
Oh god, there's more of them.
Find some cover!
Just obliterating like six mags.
Yep. Look, everyone knows the rule is one mag per person.
Outstanding warrant, armed robbery. Knocked over a drugstore back there, and it looks like he brought his whole posse with him. Bad luck for them.
They're all yours now. We need some information. Ever heard of a burglar goes by the name of Jimmy LeBlanc?
Sure. I nabbed Jimmy on a burglary beef a couple of years back. They cut through a music shop and into a jewelry store. He got 4 years. I miss his partner, though.
His partner?
Big guy. I had him cornered, and he picked up this huge display case and threw it out a plate glass window. Then he vaulted out of there like something out of Barnum and Bailey.
Got away.
I would have had him, except for LeBlanc yelling, "Run for it, Willie!"
And you think he was Willie, an acrobat of some sort?
More like a strongman, a wrestler, or a boxer, that kind of thing.
Thanks.
He had one of those mustaches, and like a leotard with only one strap.
You badly yourself.
God, that was a fucking look. Where are you going, Roy? Alright.
You're suggesting LeBlanc is still working with Willie?
Police station?
A strong man held down Randall while someone administered the morphine. Someone with muscle opened up LeBlanc's skull. Could be.
There's something naked in this
Christ!
City.
There's something what?
There's something naked in this city. This naked city here.
Any sentry
it sure is the name of the case.
3155 West 4th Street. Unit to handle code 3 identified.
Use. I am just rushing through Vice.
Just speeding directly away from Roy Earl.
Yeah. Roy Earl and the tailing mechanic.
Oh, yeah.
We caught up with Mao. He's given us the dope on LeBlanc. He worked burglaries with a big guy. Goes by the name of Willie. He might be our killer. Can you work boxing gyms, the Y, promoters, that kind of stuff?
Since when have you started giving orders, Phelps? And where's the burglary angle? There was no sign of a...
That's where our net comes in. Next stop, we speak to Lacey about a list of recent burglaries.
Yeah, Willie.
The guy's a bum. His office is a front, and he's behind on the rent and his phone bill.
And he's skipping town.
Kowski and I are on the same fucking wavelength now.
Do you want to bring in the killer, Rusty?
It could be too smart for your own good, Phelps. We've been talking about that, haven't we, Roy?
Step no!
Finbar?
Rusty, don't go to the dark side.
Sir, I need the contraband list. Item stolen over the last year.
Hang on, I'll dig out a copy for you.
What I've been trying to explain to Roy is that you work cases in your own special way.
Is the cigarette case on there?
And we really just have to step back and give you the room to move.
You were smoking a cigarette in the other room? No way.
What am I looking at? Stolen property? Oh, okay. Gold chain, emerald earring, anything? Silver pillbox. Sorry, what was that?
It's up there. The Fabergé case was at the top, and it's with that sapphire ring.
Ah.
It's here. Arnett must be out of his mind trying to move this while under a murder cloud.
Julia Randall's ring. It's here.
I have faith in the Lord. Do you, Señor?
Let me just tap a little bit more. I'm going to tap the silver pillbox, too.
Seems Julia wasn't the first bored society girl to hide her bennies in that pillbox.
Yeah. Yeah. Anthea Crawford. Also, damn. Stole a lot of shit from this person. Feel bad for them. Also, a fountain pen. fountain pens are actually pretty expensive. That's fair.
No.
I was going to say someone reported like the theft of a pen, but that's just because I don't have good pens. I wish the cars that you found showed up in here.
Yeah.
That'd be nice.
Yeah.
Still not taking Roy's car. I feel sorry for the police officer that I keep stealing shit from. Like, I just keep taking their car every single day. And it always comes back in worse shape.
So you and Rusty,
yeah, fountain pens definitely were more expensive back then.
You would like to tell me, partner?
Everything was. There was less cheap plastic crap.
Rusty had his best ever clearance rate.
You'd have like one thing, and that thing had to be there for like 10 years.
We were just
You'd be like, ah, yes, this is my iron. It was my mother's iron.
Man, Phelps. One of the best I've ever seen.
Yeah. Yeah.
Thanks. You gotta learn to take a compliment, Phelps.
Never! I will continue to be awkward about receiving compliments, as is the way of man.
Fairy tales of the rich and famous.
More like pathetic tales of the desperate to be rich and famous. Junkie Goldilocks and the Three Bears.
Arnett, LeBlanc, and Willie.
Don't you go putting the pieces together again before they fit for
I may not be able to take a compliment, Roy.
Rusty, or should I say
there's other things I could take.
I wouldn't call him that if I were.
What do you care?
Puts his four fingers together, turns his ass Christmas card list.
He gives everyone a hard time. That's just how he is.
Whatever gets you through the day, Cole.
And the moment Roy bites, just like, but not you. Never you. Just immediately baits him back. I'm a precious little boy, Roy. I'm a good boy. Operator tells me so.
Forgive me for saying so, Roy, but you seem smegmatic.
Tell me, Roy.
I get a sense.
Have you been charging your J.O. crystals properly? I know that that's an important thing for you.
Just seem a bit cheesy for me, Roy.
No, you didn't need to go there, Will. I was specifically just avoiding it. Rest in peace, Megbot.
Look out!
I start strut. I can't help it. I just love my butt. I'm a wolf on the river. I'm a wolf on the river.
And they weren't full of microplastics back then. They were just full of lard and tobacco.
First
cocaine.
Lard and tobacco, then lead.
Yeah.
Thank God we're not in my car.
See, he finally acknowledges it. Thank God we're not in his car.
Nice house.
Oh, we're stealing that car, though.
LAPD, ma'am. Is Mrs. Evestrom in?
She is. Would you follow me, sir?
Hello. I'm Mrs. Evestrom. How may I help you?
We appear to have recovered some stolen goods that belong to you, ma'am.
Yes, of course. That terrible burglary. Would you like something to drink?
No, thank you, ma'am. We have some questions, if you don't mind.
Why would I mind, young man, if you are returning 43 pieces of my property?
Okay, before we get down to that, I'll have a scotch. Thanks, straight up.
Maria, can you get the detective a drink, please?
All right. Stolen items.
Can you describe to us
if you're returning 69 pieces of my property?
It would be easier to describe what wasn't stolen, detective. A priceless tiara that has been in the family for 50 years.
50 years? That's like something you got when you were in your 20s. Come on.
And this is my Sega Genesis.
A Fabergé cigarette case that was worth $25,000. Okay.
It was not worth $25,000.
It really wasn't. It really was not worth that much money. I'm gonna yell at this old biddy.
Why are you lying about the value of your jewelry, Mrs. Eavesdrom?
Who do you think you are, making heinous accusations in my own home?
Come on, we all know. Really not worth that much. I'm gonna turn on
the light. We recovered the cigarette case from a pawnbroker. No one knows the real value of an item better than those guys.
I inflated its value for the insurance claim. There. Are you satisfied?
Lying on your insurance,
eh? My daughter's boyfriend was quite taken with the case. I think he was even more disappointed than I was when it was stolen.
$25,000 in 1947 would be $356,681.40 today. Thank you, Poi. That is some very useful information.
That's at least one expensive. Lamborghini in the Lamborghini account.
Yeah, true.
Actually, is it? Those may have gone up due to inflation.
They probably are worth more now. The burglary?
That terrible night, at least a year ago.
That's one Chevy Cruze in your Chevy Cruze account.
What you've recovered?
Oh no, $249,865. Can get a 2024 Hurricane.
Oh, nice.
Why does it? Why would you put a roof rack on it? What are you gonna do with it?
Puts a roof rack on a luxury car. Who the fuck puts a roof rack on a luxury car?
Like, I gotta copy this picture and send it to you. It's not even like an SUV. It's like,
I want to see this. I got okay. We're looking at this. One sec. I also need to refresh stream a little bit because my preview is off. All right. Hang on. Oh my God! Who does that? Who does this?
What are you gonna do? Put a kayak on there, man?
What the fuck?
Park your Lamborghini by the lift lock for a few days?
This looks fucking horrendous. No one, like, all right, if you're doing anything off-road, no one in the off-road community is gonna take you seriously. No one in the off-road community is going to take you seriously. You'll be a fucking laughingstock. And no one in the luxury sports car category is going to take you seriously either, because you put fucking roof racks on it! What the fuck? Yeah, you're just going to get stuck. They won't help. They'll do nothing.
That's all right. With my extremely low Lamborghini clearance, I'll just go under the snow. I can't take a sharp curve or a curb or anything that isn't an XL, like, ramp into a truck to the track. But I'll go under the snow.
Also, what the fuck are these lights? What are these lights doing?
They're intrigued. It's worth saying. I don't think it's actually visible. I don't know if there's a way to inflict this upon our loving community here, but oh boy.
This is awful. I've inflicted it upon the community as much as I can.
Excellent.
Oh shit. Hang on. I need to get it back up and running on this. I have to keep continually going into the game and resetting the game size. Yeah, it's the car nostrils.
Weirdly enough, that was a cross-platform bug. I dealt with that too.
Huh. Interesting. Okay. So, what the fuck was she saying?
I don't know, something true.
That terrible night at least a year ago, but let's not go into that. Let's talk about what you've recovered. I mean, something true? Sure. True.
Were you in the house when the burglary took place?
Good heavens, no. I was at a social function held by a Dr. Harold Stoneman and his lovely wife.
Oh, lovely.
I returned home and all of my
things. See, they never say, oh yeah, him and his shitty wife.
That's about it for now, Mrs. Eastrom. The department will get in touch.
Well, you know, it would be with the lovely Dr. Stoneman and his detective wife.
What else has been recovered?
You see, Phelps, that's why you get the drinks in early.
Hello, Mother. Hello, detectives.
Awkward.
What's going on?
We'd like to ask exactly the same question.
You have met my daughter?
This morning at work.
It's getting spicy.
Mother and father divorced. I took my father's name.
The detectives recovered some of the things that were stolen, darling.
Well, what did you find?
A sapphire ring on the corpse of Julia Randall.
What are you talking about?
Your engagement ring, Miss Swanson. Would you be surprised to know that it was part of the proceeds of a burglary?
That's an outrageous allegation.
Yes, it is. I suggest we go straight to Henry Arnett's place and sort this mess out.
Man.
Awkward.
And then he just brings her.
Oh, she's here.
Greeting you from
she
Los
gets
Angeles,
subjected
California,
to my driving.
KTI Radio 760.
There we go. Oh, this is great.
I'm missing something here. Arnett is obviously
and she is
burglary.
Stable. She does
That's
not
my fiance
move.
You're making scurrilous accusations about.
And Randall was obviously his partner.
My hair glue. I dribbled some of it on my neck partners. And also back and also arms.
You're being ridiculous.
And also crack.
There's a very good explanation for all of this.
What a sock in it, sister. You're being played for
a housing
you're
development.
Not even smart enough to see it.
Boy, I hope this isn't plot critical later.
Oh no! There's a corpse in one of these buildings. In the cement.
No comment.
I was gonna say, like, you're being awfully fucking quiet. You're being awfully quiet. Oh.
You're gonna meet at least one dude worse than Roy.
Yay!
Just on vibes alone.
Yay!
Well, no, he's as bad. I can't say worse. He's as bad.
I was gonna say, Roy's pretty shit. He would have to do quite a bit. I always love whenever you're watching something to just throw out two ridiculous ideas for what, like, the potential plot twist is going to be. And just...
Fish has the knife.
What?
The fish has the knife.
The fish has the knife. It makes sense.
That's where the knife went. The fish has it.
The fish has it. And just see what sticks. Like, because if you get one of them right, it's just like, oh, goddamn, that feels good. But not, like, constantly throwing out ideas. But, like, if you throw one or two ideas here and there... And one of them just so happens to be right. It's nice. Thank
you. I just put on my best Benedict Cumberbatch and go, she's going to commit suicide on the lawn at 1 minute 48 seconds, 33 seconds.
Oh, fucking Sherlock.
I can infer this because of the hairpin and the symbolism of the hairpin, which reflects a water theme in the movie. Can you just leave the movie?
Well, yeah, this stream is with Benedict Cumberbatch for his latest movie, The Shape of Water 2.
What I was going for was sort of a monster fucker vibe.
Monster fucker vibe, yes, of course. Of course. You see, in The Shape of Water 2, she is denied the monster fuckening, and that leads her to suicide. Of course. Of course, you're able to predict this in the first 5 minutes of the movie if you're paying attention to the subtle details, such as the fine print on the newspaper that I'm reading.
No, I had insisted on Martin sister. Freeman for the monster.
Let's find out who your fiancé really is.
I got an achievement! I did all that without damaging my vehicle, apparently.
I'm pretty sure you did.
Roy is like... Before we go to the car, he's like, Jesus Christ, this is gonna be bad, this is gonna be bad. He starts, like, warning her about it, and the entire time, he's just like, The fuck? And just gaslighting him into thinking that I'm a bad driver.
Welcome, sir. I'm sorry, are you a resident?
Hello.
LAPD detectives. We're here to speak
to you. Oh, no, I got the hiccups.
Oh, Mr. Arnett, apartment 30. You can take the lift. Thank you.
It's all right. I'll try to scare you. Hold on. Car payment.
Oh, God. That's horrifying.
Wow. Isn't this just nice?
Don't even own a car.
Skills retraining at 40.
Oh no! Terrible.
It's just a weird quirk of history where somehow they're coming to you, a programmer, going, hey, we're gonna teach you how to coal mine.
He's dead.
Stop! LAPD!
Don't kill him, Cole! This guy's our case!
Go on,
put your hands in the air!
Alright, fine. Ready to go.
Give it up, LAPD.
Oh, get back here.
Don't make me chase you.
Come on. Come on.
He's gonna try to bonk you around that corner. I know it.
Oh, he bonked me. Oh, I see. We blacked out. It was such a sudden cut. I'm like, there's no scuffle,
like you got
nothing.
Good, Phelps. Yeah, he really packs a wallop. How did I get back here?
Under your own steam, miraculously. You came in through the window, said hello, and then keeled over.
Sounds about right.
How was Arnett?
He's coming around too. He's all hopped up. Good time to get some answers.
You missing something, Henry?
Just gonna open this up. Aha! Uh-huh.
You told Heather you're honeymooning without her?
Nice watch. Come on. No. Oh. Oh.
Vacheron Constantine. That's an extremely expensive watch, Henry.
A graduation present from my parents.
Sure. Alright, that's it. The fuck? This guy owns a fucking sword.
Amazing.
That's Jesus Christ. This dude is everything terrible.
I think that's all you need. Is going to be relevant.
All right, fine. But I still want to look around. There might be a newspaper like this one. See if they have any. Oh, they do have some vegetables all chopped up here.
Incidental.
Yes, vegetables.
It is honestly shocking how little brain power I have to dedicate to flipping it in my head.
Yeah. You just waggle it.
Yeah. Why do I get the feeling that this dude has, like, a racist obsession with, I'm going to say China, because that sword looks more like on the Chinese side of things. I don't know the specific name for the sword.
Circumstantial.
I don't even know what it is. Okay. So, is that a matchbox, or is that like, is that a condom? Like that.
I think that's a matchbox.
Okay. Because now I just thought of, like, the ultimate burn essentially being Phelps looking at another dude's dick and going, circumstantial. Jesus Christ.
Why are people dropping half-smoked cigars on the fucking floor?
I don't know, dude. He was just assaulted. Maybe that was it.
He got punched out of him.
Yeah, exactly. He didn't have time to put a stogie out. All right.
We know all about the jewelry ring. You and Randall and LeBlanc and Willie doing the legwork.
I'm in the fashion business.
Are you now? Okay. Let's just see what the lie is.
You're lying, Henry.
How can you prove that I'm involved, detective?
And fucking look. The look at the end there was like, fuck, I shouldn't have said that. I mean, the Fabergé cigarette case that you pawned?
Yeah, that's got a tie to you.
Because you pawned a Fabergé cigarette case today for $600. A case that is on a list of stolen items.
And is actually worth $10,000.
Get a list of society parties, and find out where and when, and then have to guess probe. Julia was desperate for money. No matter how much you had made, she always wanted more.
She is so offended. I like that her head isn't looking anywhere, but her mouth is just agape.
Yeah.
Why did Reed and LeBlanc?
She's looking intently at something.
I wanted to stop to get out of that life.
She's the YouTuber's girlfriend on the couch in the apology video.
She was gonna create a new gang.
Like, the YouTuber just starts going off on a fucking rant, completely off script, and she just looks at him like, no, 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 you're making it worse. Okay.
Just mumbling really quietly, like, so the reason you engaged in certain problem behavior. Certain problem was so the reason. So the reason I engaged.
The reason why I'm accused of being engaged in certain things.
Saw through that, you knew it was time to run.
The reason I'm engaged in jail.
Nothing to do with Julia's death. Why would I need to run?
You're not supposed to say that. Oh, what did he even say? I wasn't. I told you I was involved in the Nothing to do with Julius Seth. Why would I need to run? You know, this train ticket to Mexico?
Have you told Miss Swanson that you're leaving for Mexico City tomorrow night? That it's a one-way ticket?
Henry? Tell me it isn't true.
Henry?
Choice.
Henry, come on.
I wanted to marry Heather. I told Julia I wanted out, and she laughed in my face. To pay Willie and Jimmy a fortune to do her, and now I'm completely broke.
What you are, Buster, is under arrest.
So this is going great.
Who is Henderson, and what is his involvement?
Tell them what you know, Henry. I'll stand by you if you'll only tell the truth.
Wow.
There is no Henderson.
That is loyalty.
Stand by if you tell the truth. Immediately lies.
Yeah.
Tell me about your first burglary, and don't lie.
I can't remember. I don't keep a list of these things.
Is it the watch?
The contraband list.
Yeah.
It's like, you do this for a living. You.
Your first burglary was a Dr. Harold Stoneman. You want to explain how he is involved, or shall I?
Henderson is Stoneman. He was crazy about Julia. She could get him to do whatever she wished. He threw the parties, and we arranged the burglaries.
Oh, yeah, that makes sense.
Touch her. She just kept him hanging on a promise. Drove the good doctor almost insane.
Henry Arnett, you are under arrest.
Why do I feel like I know the actor for that? Just because of, like, some slight glance.
Henderson is Stoneman, all right? I'm not the guy you want. Go talk to the good doctor.
Oh, we will, knucklehead. Meanwhile, we're fitting you for combat stripes.
Hey. I love a nice uckle. A knucklehead, a chuckle fuck.
All very quality.
And now, you hear him. KTI, Big Joe Turner.
I don't know why, but I saw the actor. I saw the actor for Cole Phelps on IMDb, and I'm like, hey, he actually looks like the character. And then I remembered literally the entire point of this game and all of its, like, technology. And I was just like, fuck. Okay, I found the guy, and I don't actually recognize him in anything. So I can move on with my life.
He's fella shaped.
Yep, he's fella shaped. He's got Henry Cavill kind of energy.
Well,
LAPD, police emergency.
Like,
what are you doing?
Police emergency, hope you understand.
I guess the wedding's off.
He only robbed her mother and killed her best friend. Cut the guy some slack.
So how does the doctor
do? They can work
That's
it out.
That's what we're about to find
a
out.
Bit of therapy.
Maybe we should ask him to
fine.
Give you a quick once-over. That meathead gave you one hell of a pasting.
I've had worse.
You should have seen yourself staggering back in there like a drunken sailor.
Next time you can take the runner, Roy.
I didn't box in the Marines, though, did I?
I should have never told you that.
I told you that in confidence. There were many soldiers in my box.
I still remember Boxing Day.
Oh, God, no, not Boxing Day. I think Mad Men was one of the biggest things. Oh, yeah, I never
you
actually watched
idiot.
Mad Men. I have a feeling at some point Saladril's just gonna be like, what have you actually watched? Because apparently it's not a whole lot.
Are you crazy?
It didn't give
Is
us a
cutscene. Is the window still open?
Yes.
Hmm.
Someone's going out it. Oh, there's even a car underneath it? Oh, God. Sneaking in the back. No one will know.
That's why they call me a backdoor man, Roy.
Time for the doctor to give us something to make this all better.
Yeah, I heard Mad Men is good if you can get past the, like, era-accurate sexism. Like, it's all accurate, but, like, yikes. Sometimes you're just not here for that energy.
Hang on a moment, sister.
Sometimes it's over your toots per hour.
It's Henry yeah. and Matt. And tell him it's urgent.
I can't do that.
Tell him, or I'll charge you with obstruction of justice.
Doctor, I'm afraid Mr. Arnett is here to see you, and he says it's urgent.
It is currently 9 p.m., and one of my neighbors is apparently sawing something.
I told you never to come. Tell us the truth, Doctor.
I mean, I've heard sawing logs before as a euphemism, but...
Yeah.
Isn't way better than insanity, and I'm already half insane.
They're doing something, all right, whatever.
Do you know that I loved her?
It's far enough away that it's not picking up on the mic, so I'm fine with it.
And yet, I still love her. Will you testify in court that Arnett and Randall did these robberies?
Am I gonna lose my job?
They organized the robberies. Julie would get the names of the guests attending my wife's parties. Didn't matter how much money I showered upon her, it was never enough. She never really cared for me.
Doctor, I'm afraid you're under arrest.
I'm losing my job.
Oh, the practice. You'll call Dr. Gerard. No. Please don't cry. I want to see no one. Not my wife, or my children, nor my friends. And I don't want a lawyer. Just lock me up and throw away the key.
Oh, no one went out through the window.
What have I done?
Oh, no, there it goes.
Didn't see that coming.
The delivery on that was a little flat.
Yeah. Yeah. The foreshadow window, yeah. You could, like, swan dive, too.
Call this in, Cole. Maybe
operator,
you should ask
message
for
KGPL.
Sweeper.
Yeah, that was very, very sudden. It was like, just don't tell anyone. I don't want anyone. I don't want to see one. I'll go quietly.
The offices of Dr. Harold
Stone, you know
what,
on second thought?
Ivor Street, Hollywood.
Thank God it's not my car.
We have a message. Detective Bukowski
fuck
says the
Christ.
Suspect is named Wilson Willie the Wolf Reed, former wrestler. Last known address is an apartment building at the corner of Hollywood and Vine.
All right, time for someone else to die.
Detective Bukowski says to meet them there.
On our way.
Man, this is a lot of arrests.
We have an address for the runner.
Let's try and wrap this up then.
It's just people resisting arrest, like, the whole way down.
Yeah. No one wants to go quietly. Yeah, I wouldn't wrestle
that
someone named Willie.
Really fell for that broad.
They're slippery
she
folk.
She was incredibly beautiful.
Ain't that right, Willie?
Would you throw it all away for a woman?
Life has a way.
Feels
I'm not a Willie.
You were not. Just in no way are you ever. Nope.
You're talking from experience.
I certainly am. Oh, I like women as much as the next guy. As long as they're in their place and doing what they're told.
Fucking Christ, Roy.
Thank God I didn't park there.
I've got friends that work.
For some reason, the body reminds me of when a body glitches out in a video game. And, like, the limbs just look longer than... Yeah, he fucking said it. He just wants women in their place. Jesus Christ.
Best live programming and transcribed shows.
Yeah.
KDI's.
The plot of this case is just... it's nonsense.
Yep.
It's like, ah, a guy, and he's gonna do a Hollywood thing. Ah, a guy, and he's gonna do a Hollywood thing.
Yeah.
Oops.
There we go. Needed to happen. You did the thing about being happy you didn't park there. That is true. You did do the thing.
Where did they come from?
Okay, there we go. We can go now.
Just drive a block.
Yep. It was necessary, Will. It was necessary. Where did they come from?
He's around here somewhere. A big guy. Neighbors say he always wears basketball shoes and a cream jacket. And get this. The kids around here say he plays the harmonica.
Find a game, Will, and have the commander set up a dragnet. We want the area closed off. We'll take this out of the street.
A harmonica nice playing wrestler. That's a weird one.
Love that sometimes, well, like, Bukowski will be super helpful, then you'll turn around, bark something at him, and he leaves, and he's like, this guy.
This fucking guy, what the fuck? I hear harmonica. Yeah. It's Wilson antiques Reed, or maybe LAPD, current peaks. Exactly. Give yourself up. Wow. Sturdy motherfucker.
He's beefy.
He got a harmonica gun.
You just keep magically shooting him in the harmonica.
Do it. Damn it. I thought he was gonna climb something. I'm going up because the arrow says up. He must want puppies. Well, this is gonna end with me getting my head bopped again. Will he want puppies? He always wants uppies.
Hold it. He's got to be around here somewhere. No place to go unless he grew wings. There he is. Place the son of a bitch.
Can I just shoot the entire, like... How sturdy is this fucker? Jesus Christ.
Son of a bitch really picked a spot for it up here, didn't he?
Steve Buscemi?
Julia Randall's folks are flying in.
It sounded like him for a little while. The body.
I saw her on the slab. So perfect.
Looked Could like have shot the letters more? Damn it, I'm assuming there's an achievement
really
for that.
She really made an impression on me.
Julia had that impact on a lot of men.
Yeah, you got up to bro.
Christ, it's cold.
Yeah,
you guys did good work here today. Roy!
That's the way it goes sometimes.
I think you should buy your brother officers a drink. Do you now? That's very generous of you.
Sometimes you just
Lieutenant.
Reach... Bro. Eight million stories. Yeah, more like 8 million endings. Fucking Christ. There were more endings in that one than fucking Lord of the Rings.
It is really fun when you reach the end of the Lord of the Rings and you still have like a quarter inch of book left.
More endings than the Clue movie. Yes.
But what if this happened?
But what if this happened?
To
takes a dump at the theater you're in.
But what if Mr. Green was gay? Which, I mean, as a person who owns Clue and various Clue-associated games, like the original PC game of Clue, Mr. Green definitely had gay vibes.
The 20 count's still firing, Cole! The 22nd is still firing!
Oh, Professor Plum, they had different gay vibes. Like, Professor Plum had twink vibes. Mr. Green just had, I am gay, and it's quite possible that I'm still in the closet about it.
It's over, Cole.
Ah, Professor Plum, get out of here. You're making me think things.
It's like you're one of the lucky ones.
Say goodbye to your friend Hank, Jack.
He was your friend too, Cole. Is this how you're going to leave him? Are you wounded?
Not a scratch, Kelso.
Well, get up and get out of that fucking hole! Find a stretcher while you're at it so we can get him out of here!
Who's the senior officer here?
I guess that's you, Cole.
You were up here all night?
Yes, sir.
And your command?
Gone, sir.
Sorry to hear that, son. God damn it, we have beaten these bastards back! It's the beginning of the end, and it was one here. You're a goddamn hero, son.
You had to look it up.
Son.
You see it? Yeah.
What's your name?
He's like
Lieutenant Phelps.
Yeah,
sir.
I'm recommending
There's
you for
like
the Silver Star.
There's like a very small part of me
promoting you to first lieutenant
that had their gay awakening from Mr. Green, Clue, and also had their gay awakening from Professor Plum in Clue.
Mm-hmm.
But not Colonel Mustard. Colonel Mustard says like he sounds like he's canceled on Twitter.
Earl Phelps, a shooting at the 111 Club, 6232 Hollywood Boulevard. Sounds like a homicide beef. Two of the dead guys caught in the crossfire were carrying army surplus morphine. Get
oh yay, more morphine.
Travels all over the place. We already cleared that up.
I Judge fucking love how this captain is just yesterday.
He
so
had a personal
bad.
Stash of 20 cigarettes. Yeah. Appears we
He's
didn't.
He's just done with Roy's shit, and I'm here for it. Yeah, morphine. As in, there's always
the
more.
Ooh.
Look
and
at
you become a fiend?
Yeah.
God damn it. Just can't seem to put this morphine to sleep. A dead judge.
Uh-huh.
It's not good.
Fuck am I?
Everyone has their vices. Even you, Phelps.
I see we busted near.
My vice is putting people behind bars. Yeah, we need more lesbian and non-morphine. 100%. Parking lot, that way.
He's only a rider, so he can't really help me.
Hey, boy, don't compliment Roy for something that he said. You know, is yeah. Don't give any credit to him. One of those things. You take that. You take that and you take full credit for it. Ooh, red car. Just damaged his car and left it. But look at how red this one is.
Oh, it's red for a
you
reason.
Gotta be kidding me.
Yes.
You're driving this.
Fuck, it's huge!
This is massive!
Parker and Green
Never
are going toe-to-toe toe for the top job. There's a change in the wind.
Let's
About
go!
This wind will be like a tornado, Phelps. Parker's got a puritanical streak. You never know we'll get swept up in a thing like that.
This thing does not handle well. This thing looks like it's meant to drive into a burning building, and it would damage the building more than the car. No. No.
It's just a road boat.
I mean, I literally just pushed that car out of my way. What's the siren like? Oh. Yeah, different siren. Oh, this is great. No. Oh my god.
You better not get blood in this car.
That was fucking full brakes.
Yeah.
Trying to turn. We will, we will, we will.
Homicide guys are already inside.
Yeah, if we get blood on the car, it blends right in. It's perfect.
Bukowski. Phelps.
More Bukowski.
We're here about the morphine. Over by the bandstand. You can see what's left of the owner, Eddie McGoldrick, 26, former Marine.
I know Eddie McGoldrick. He was a non-com in my old unit.
I'm sorry to hear that, Cole. Waitress said he recently came into some money and bought the club.
Who are the other Vicks?
By
two musicians, Biddlestone
Army
and Bo.
Surplus morphine?
Get this, they used to be in a four-piece, but the trombone player and the drummer OD'd.
Don't tell me. Lamont and Tyree? We've met the rest of the band.
Now they're a no-piece.
Do you mind if we take a look around?
They're dead, guest? Roy.
You might want a word with the hostess, too. I'll keep her company until you're ready.
Rusty comes out, he's like, did somebody say One Piece?
Oh, do I have opinions on One Piece? Let me tell you. Can you believe what they did in the live-action remake? This appears to be some sort of cigarette. Now what they really should have done if they wanted to separate the live action from the anime is the inclusion of Hatsune Miku.
When we have a civil conversation, we can try again.
Rusty just walks in cosplaying as Luffy. I am going to be king of the police. Okay. Buddy. Yeah,
slightly gunned.
Trust me, Phelps, you just have to watch 350 episodes, and it gets real good after that. Oh, fucking Christ. I hate that argument so goddamn much. Source,
or is this coming from what's left in circulation?
Well, what's your opinion on, like, skipping bad arcs when you haven't, like, seen the show? But everyone says, like, oh, this is a bad arc, you can just skip it. Are you inclined to just skip it, or do you watch it anyway?
I am not gonna sit there in my time for having fun and not have fun.
Army surplus again. A Goldrick must have been moving contraband through the club.
That's fair.
I do have morbid curiosity, so I'll be like, oh, this is a bad one, and then watch it, but like...
Yeah.
But I appreciate knowing.
For me, I am of the mindset of if a show can't keep me interested through the bad times, it...
Never fired.
It's not worth watching.
Haven't been degreased yet.
Mm-hmm.
We could check
like,
on the show
that's
numbers.
The reason why I will this never watch One Piece.
Look at these things.
Because...
They're BARs.
I have watched the first couple episodes, and it was boring as hell. But then people tell me it gets good after 350 episodes, which is not just because of the meme. I genuinely had a friend tell me that it gets good. You just have to, like, either skip or watch, like, sit through 100 episodes. I'm like, I'm sorry, man. No. It violates my principles.
Like, maybe it's just
skip
mid
shit.
Then?
Hmm?
Like, maybe it's just mid then?
Yeah, like, maybe One Piece is just kind of qualifies as mid at that point.
Like, I've seen so many things where people are like, this is the greatest thing ever, this is the greatest piece of anime, and it's like, it's fine.
It's mid! It's mid. Uh. probably depends on how much you care about the show. Might recommend skipping based on... Yeah. If it's based on, like, recommendations, you might do it. I genuinely can't. Like...
It's dumb. It's fun. It's dumb. You're not gonna have an intellectual time. You're not gonna be impressed by the artistic notes and the subtleties of the metaphor. He goes gum gum, he punches the guy, and the guys get bigger. And sometimes that's what you need. I've watched a lot of One Piece just because it was the thing I was putting on.
Yeah, like, that's fair. I just... The way... Oh.
Neat trick.
Neat.
Ace must have cost more than the trick.
The way I've always viewed stuff is just, like... If I don't want to watch something, I'm not going to watch it. If I don't want to play a video game, then I'm not going to play a video game.
Find anything interesting?
This is like a weird opinion that I developed when all of my friends were telling me to play the Assassin's Creed games. So I bought Assassin's Creed 1 and I bought Assassin's Creed 2. I played Assassin's Creed 1 and I hated it. Assassin's Creed 1 is not a good game.
Yeah.
But everyone was telling me, no, no, no. You play every other Assassin's Creed game. Assassin's Creed 1 is terrible. Assassin's Creed 2 is legendary. Assassin's Creed 3 is bad. Assassin's Creed 4 is fucking, like, amazing. And in that moment, like, something broke inside of me, and I just couldn't. I was just like, from then on, I was a changed man. And I was like, I have to have context for things. I need to have the story. Like, all of the subtle details that you get out of the games would be completely lost on me, and I can't have that. If I'm going to experience the media, I need to experience the media.
Well, that's kind of why, like, if people ask me for recommendations, I'm not going to go, oh, what's a crowd please? I'm going to go, like, okay, you asked me.
Yeah.
Because when you get recommendations from someone, it's always so colored by who they are, right?
Right.
You'll be like, oh, what's good movies? Somebody will be like, oh, everything Quentin Tarantino has ever done, and also, like, Rocky.
Yeah.
And then someone else will be like, oh, yeah, here's a couple of Russian films and some French films, and even some American ones, Gasp. Yeah. And someone else will be like... Okay, Die Hard, Horrible Bosses, Despicable Me 2.
Meanwhile, it's just like, oh, you want me to recommend a movie? How about Enchaîne Andalou? Let's go with, like, French classic cinema where it has really fucking disturbing imagery. You know what? That's probably not for you. It's fun. I'm gonna throw out some wild shit to see how people react to it and then get a genuine, like, recommendation. Probably an Edgar Wright film. More than likely, it's going to be an Edgar Wright film.
Ma'am, I'm Detective Phelps, administrative vice squad.
Welcome to the 111 Club, Detective.
Happy to be
here. Feels
like
I've had half the LAPD in here today already.
What about Edgar Wrong? That's the good part. He's never wrong.
Any idea who did the shooting?
No idea. It was my day off. If I had been here, honey, I'd be full of holes just like the others.
Like, the best part about Edgar Wright films is even if you don't like the film, it's pretty much just mid. Yeah, how dare she say that she'd be full of holes? Is very lewd. I mean, we didn't find anything else. We have no reason to. Any idea who did the shooting? I mean, she kind of looks like she knows. Like, she's rolling her eyes on me. I think we press her.
Do it. Hydraulic.
Level with me, miss, before we start taking an interest in you.
This place has been on the slide for years. Eddie turns up, buys the club. Then we start getting visits from tough guys. Next thing you know, we have the St. Valentine's Day Massacre. Are you getting the picture?
I see.
Tell us about Eddie.
Eddie didn't know a thing about running a nightclub. He came into some money and waltzed in and bought the place. The previous owner thought all his Christmases had come at once.
Imagine buying a business that you know nothing about. Crazy. Yeah,
I wonder what that's like.
Can't imagine a person doing that.
I wonder what it's like working for such a person. And you're trying to explain industry standard, and they're like, but I'm an innovator.
I'm an innovator. I'm going to revitalize the entire industry. The fact that I'm new, that I'm young blood, means that I have fresh ideas.
Mm-hmm.
That totally aren't bad. I have no reason to doubt her on this one. This feels like a truth.
Where do you think you got the money?
My guess was that he was selling the sort of quality product that you don't need to advertise.
Thank you for your help, man.
I mean,
Eddie was in over his head.
Some morphine he here, so yeah. Boss. Can I pick up their hat? Damn it. Alright, is it doing a weird bug thing, or... Oh, corner. Can I talk to you about it? No? Is it still just zooming in on the body? Okay. Still just zooming in on the body. Hello. Oh, shit, there is a whole other room. Did not even notice this.
I'll be right back.
Okay.
Bad luck, Ed. Okinawa couldn't kill you, but knowing the wrong people in this city...
I mean, Okinawa didn't manage to kill us either. You're doing great. Appears to be some sort of bullet hole in his head. And chest. I'd say cause of death, singular gunshot wound to the head. Oh, the other ones didn't really cause the death, but, you know, definitely helped. Okay, he didn't have any fun on him. Anything in the safe?
They didn't even try to crack the safe.
What the fuck? They left the gun, the money... ammo. That's good shit. They could have definitely taken that. You have anything to say, Mr. Coroner?
I'll have my report when it's ready. Right now, you want to be examining evidence.
But I did all the evidence. All right. Well, let's do another pass and see what we can find. Was there anything on this? Probably not. It's a cigarette box. There isn't really a whole lot going on with that. Anything cool over here, bud? Ooh, matchsticks. Fascinating. But like, damn, what happened there? No, not the matchsticks. Can I get behind the counter? It does not appear to be anything behind the counter. Will, are you good? I think Will has stepped away. So, you know, we have that. We have the blue room ticket. Sure. Really anything else going on there. If I examine you, There's no examine further. Can I look down? Thing? Nope. Hello. Mm,
jazz, huh?
I like jazz. There was
well,
this.
I think you found just about all of it.
Have I? Is it doing that thing again?
Yep.
Damn it. I only got like two things in my clues.
Mm-hmm.
That's it? Alright. Oh, I guess I have four now. What about this broom? Nothing. Alright. How you feeling, Will?
A little weary. How are you?
I say we hop in the fire truck and
fine.
Possibly but save it there, and we'll do the rest of it next time.
Yeah.
Let's go.
That last one kind of started to drag, eh?
It really fucking did, yeah. It, like, when you have to go and arrest four separate people in four separate locations to get four separate endings, it really feels like a really long mission.
Mm-hmm.
And when you're with this asshole the entire time.
Yeah.
Ugh.
He's like, huh, women, smackable, right? And you're like,
ugh. That's a whole criminal case in and of itself. I have to sneeze.
Something, something, 40% of Roy Earl is Roy Earl.
Yeah. Yep. Something, something, yes. I read the numbers underneath fire as Fire Bob.
Huh?
I'm like, yeah, all right, this is Fireman Bob signing off.
This is your local Fire Bob signing off.
All right. So, hopefully everyone had a good time with that. I sure did. It was a long case, though, but holy crap, you had some fun there throughout.
It was very Nya Hollywood.
It really was. It was very Nya Hollywood. Okay, well, we'll be back next time with Phelps and Roy and the Vice Desk. And hopefully, eventually, we'll finish the Vice Desk.
And escape from this miserable man.
Yeah, escape from this miserable, jealous man. Alright. Thank you for watching, and we'll see y'all next time. Bye-bye.
Peace.